Mr. Paul Shaffer, welcome back to the show. Bob Shaw will be here, and the gentleman who invented the Nautilus equipment, and my first guest in 1977. This gentleman released an album entitled Bat Out of Hell that was one of the most successful debut albums in rock history. Since then, he's done a lot of different things, and we're going to talk about some of those right now. Please welcome the legendary... Meatloaf.
Well, I had to dress up for this today.
You look great, and
spiffy.
I enjoyed you laughing at your own introduction. I thought that shows it's a
introductions are always funny.
Point of character there.
Yeah.
I appreciate that.
Here, I brought you a T-shirt.
Oh, great! I enjoy T-shirts.
Hey guys, just like always, band doesn't get one. You know what I mean?
Oh, this is nice.
Is this
from the new album?
From the last album.
From the last album.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Well, that's
there
okay.
You go.
It's the newest one.
And you brought enough of these for the audience? That's really nice.
Yeah, they're $7.50 a piece for the audience.
we have some, I guess this is concert footage of you. We're going to...
It is concert footage.
Okay.
It's good guess.
All right.
I knew you were quick, man. I've been watching you for years.
I'm having a slow decade. So why don't you, I'll just go backstage. You tell them what we're going to see.
Well, they told me a while ago, so we're both sort of, they said it was sort of at the end of Bat Out of Hell. We did this in, they asked me, April 27th in Wembley, mm-hmm. which is in England, mm-hmm. in London. And so this is live.
This is a big...
With an audience and everything.
Soccer
yeah.
stadium, is that what Wembley is?
No, it's a, I don't think so. It's indoors.
Oh, no. Well,
No, it's just, shh. Anyways.
I have
trying
a
to get this
rapport
out.
With these people.
I do. I bought them all here.
So it's not important.
I brought them all. Picked them up in the Melman bus, man. I don't know why you're kidding me.
It's not important what the venue is, but
that's
it was
right,
Wembley.
Yeah. It was Wembley, and it's indoors. It's like the Garden, Madison Square Garden.
So this was actually from your concert at the
yeah,
Garden?
Yeah, actually. Yeah.
Okay. Good enough. So here in action, Meatloaf, Bat Out of Hell, 19...
I hope.
Okay. Meatloaf in London. We're going to be right back to continue talking with Meatloaf, folks. Come on back. Welcome back to the show, and this gentleman, of course, is Meatloaf, and you're going to play tennis. You have a big... Tell me about your... You play tennis.
Yeah, I play... In fact, I even had a lesson about a month ago.
Yeah? So
yeah. Yeah, with
class.
A real pro and everything, you know?
But you have
out
a big...
Out of Connecticut.
You got a function coming up here, huh?
Yeah.
Tell me about that.
Do you want to know about that?
Sure.
Okay. I'm playing tennis with John McEnroe and Vitas Gerulaitis. And Andy Summer of the Police. And, Andy Summer, come on. He'll appreciate it. So, and it's for the Gerulaitis, I got to remember this, the Gerulaitis Youth Foundation and the World Hunger Project and Celebrity Palsy, Cerebral Palsy. That's not funny. Not funny. That's
no,
not. You're gonna
no,
get letters
no.
now,
yeah,
boy.
No, you're
in trouble.
You're gonna get the letters.
No, they don't know my address.
But that, you know, and where and when did we cover that?
Oh no, we didn't cover that. It's at Forest Hills. This is Forest Hills. They clap at everything.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, on Wednesday. Wednesday. Yeah. August 25th. Yeah.
Unbelievable, ladies and gentlemen.
And I don't know the time of day, but there's a lot of other people there. Charlie Daniels. Not the time of day. Charlie Daniels and. Joe Cocker.
Long tennis buffs,
yeah,
these guys. Yeah, they
Connors,
go.
Yeah, yeah, Charlie
they
Daniels.
Go way back. let me...
Charlie Daniels, of course, will wear his hat during
yeah.
the match.
Yeah, he was here and wore his hat here and chewed gum. Wouldn't
and
stop
he couldn't
gum.
See anything either, right?
Nope, nope. Tell me about you. Before you became a big success on your own, you did many, many other things, and you worked with Ted Nugent. You sang in a group. what was any interesting experiences happened with Mr. Nugent traveling across the country?
Well, I didn't actually ever travel with him. He asked me to, but I went to one of the shows, and I couldn't hear for about 10 days after that. And so I said, well, I better not do it with Ted. And I've known Mr. Nugent, as he's referred to, for about 15 years. So, and there is one incident that I know about. Well, see, I did travel with Ted in the late 60s. I opened to him. I was with a band called the Popcorn Blizzard. we opened to Ted, and we were in Lima, Ohio at the Lima, Ohio Rock... Will you give me a break? The Lima, Ohio Rock Festival. There's nothing like... And so Ted asked me for his set to open these doors, and he came out stark naked, the boy did, with his guitar. And he almost... Then another time, he jumped in the water down in Miami and almost drowned. So that's some Ted Nugent stories.
Now, how does this work in Lima, Ohio, a man standing there nude on stage? Is that...
I don't think they knew it. That's how it worked.
It's kind of the ultimate insult there, isn't it? A man's naked and nobody knew it. What are we going
to
do?
An insult to Lima, Ohio, or an insult to Ted Nugent?
Something. We'll figure that out and come back. But we're going away, but we'll be back. Is that what we're doing?
Yeah, we'll be right back.
All right, we'll be right back.
Yeah. Hello, love. This is Larry Bud Melman here to tell you we're letting our hair down and reliving the 60s. Every alternate Tuesday this summer with our magical mystery, Melman Bus Tours. It's the hippest thing to come on the scene since Inagata Da Vida hit the charts just 14 short years ago. So whether you're going a short distance or one that's far out, you'll want to get your head together for the most mind-expanding trip in town, a trip on a Melman bus.
Welcome back to the show. Arthur Jones will be with us, the man who invented the Nautilus machines, and comedian Bob Shaw. This gentleman, of course, is Meatloaf. You're one of the few world-class rock and rollers, as we say, who has done any recording with Phil Rizzuto, the Scooter.
Absolutely.
Tell us about that.
You mean that Huckleberry? I mean, holy cow, Scooter Rizzuto. Phil Rizzuto, he was hysterical. Art Shamsky, who used to play... for the Mets in 1969, the Miracle Mets, was, I don't know if he still is, Phil Rizzuto's agent. And so Phil Rizzuto wanted to know through Art Shamsky if you had to get high to listen to the record. And we told him that it would probably be better with this record than if you didn't, you know. Uh-huh. So he came in and we gave him a script. And it was written by my partner Jim Steinman. And it had... Phil Rizzuto, you know, language in it, like holy cow, and he's got a beat on the ball and all that good stuff, you know. And he couldn't do it. I mean, he could not say holy cow when it was written on a piece of paper. You know, holy cow, you know. And we sat in there for the longest time, and we paid him, a certain amount of money, and he continues on the air. They continue to tell him, hey, do you know how many records that sold? You know, you really got screwed, Phil, you know.
What was his reaction after the record came out and he heard himself?
Oh, he said... Well, see, he didn't know anything about it. His kids live in Boston. They brought him home the record and said, Dad, you're on this record. And he said, yeah, I did this record, you know. And he said, he keeps saying that he got a lot of letters from Priest. And because he was on Paradise by the Dashboard Light. And he was doing a baseball play-by-play, which was also the old, you know, first base, second base thing. But he didn't actually know that when he was doing it. But it was really supposed to be on the radio, a baseball play. You know, it just happened, you know, the heavy breathing behind it just, you know, fit in good.
So are you and Phil buddies to this
day? Yeah. I see him, you know, when I, like at the ballpark and things. And he continues, you know, he says, calls me a Huckleberry on the air all the time. And he got a lot of press. I gave him a platinum record, and I gave the Yankees a platinum record. And I met Jackson that day, too, you know. First thing Reggie Jackson asked me, we were introduced, and he says, what kind of percentage you make on your records? I said, what's your contract call for, Reggie? You know, how many times a bet do you...
Let me ask you about, in addition to being a singer and rock music legend. That's where you
rock music. I don't know about that.
What about your performance in the Rocky Horror Picture Show? Do you ever go see that in front of the regular midnight audience?
Yeah, I went. I went one time, I guess in about 1978. You know, and I went to the in New York. It plays. It used to play at the Waverly. They've since had a riot, and it doesn't play there anymore. And so I went, and it was sold out. And I had a bunch of friends with me. And it was real embarrassing, and I never do this, but this time I decided, well, look, I got to go up and tell them I'm Meatloaf and I'm in the movie. Well, they didn't believe me. I mean, they go, you're not Meatloaf. I said, yeah, I am. They no, you're not. So finally I convinced them. They said, you better be. So they let me in. They said, you better be Meatloaf, because we're sitting you right here where we can watch you. You know? So I said, okay, fine, you know. And so they sent me with all these people, and this was in 1978, and this particular person in one side sat next to me and seen it 220 times in a row. The one over here had seen it like 150, and they were, you know, that they were, you know, and they were going to me, here, you want some? I'm going, no, it's okay, you know, and these people were going, oh, wow, you know, and they weren't watching the movie at all, yeah. But it was like, it was total insanity. Tim Curry actually went once, and they didn't know it was him, because he doesn't look like that character, you know, everybody else looks like him more than he does. They dress up, and in fact, Los Angeles, somebody got married as
right there at the
Eddie,
performance.
The character I played in the Rocky Horror Show, right out on Sunset Boulevard. I went a couple of times when we were at, you know, when I was promoting Bat, you know, just went around, because we had a trailer that was running in front of the movie of some of the songs from Bat Out of Hell, so I went and asked a lot of questions. I mean, they're fun and everything, but they are out there.
It's interesting that you have to prove that you're Meatloaf to get in. That's I remember the rap.
I don't know, how do you prove that? You
Meatloaf
know, how do you
imposters
prove
there for a while.
Oh, there it. Listen.
Really?
Oh, there. Oh, this guy. Oh, good. Thank you for bringing that up. You know, I need to bring it up. There is this guy in California, who goes around impersonating me, and I sometimes stay at the Beverly Hills Hotel. We called up for a reservation, and they said, you're persona non grata. I said, what the hell does that mean? You know, and they said, well, you can't get in. I said, why not? Why? You know, and they said, because, you know, you flipped a coin with our night manager and beat him out for $20,000 a room. So I said, what? I did what? And then somebody asked me, did you do that? And I said, what are you, not? This guy goes around L.A. and different places, and he's a gambler.
Yeah.
And he flips coins. In fact, the FBI called me up one day, and I thought, who? What did I? And, you know, and they wanted to question me. It was about this guy. So if anybody got involved with this particular person, let me do this. If anybody got involved with this particular person, ignore him. It's not me.
Well, he's here tonight, Meat, and
listen, by the way, this is your life.
By the way,
you got a coin?
No. We have to go. Good luck on your tennis tournament.
Oh, thank you.
Pleasure meeting
you. I wish you'd come and play.
Well, come back anytime, sir.
Hey, thank you very much.
Meatloaf, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be right back with Arthur Jones, the man who invented the Nautilus equipment. Anybody lose a hand out there with the doggies? That's good. Next week, I'm hoping for poodles. 16 years ago, our next guest's debut album, entitled Bat Out of Hell, sold over 25 million copies. And now he has released this CD right here, Bat Out of Hell 2. Ladies and gentlemen, here he is, Meatloaf. We'll be right back.
ever built to really last.
What about your family?
It's defective.
All the batteries are shot.
What about your friends?
They're defective.
All the parts are out of stock.
What about home?
It's defective.
It's corroded and decayed.
What about me? Oh.
It's defective.
It's tattered and it's frayed.
Meatloaf.
How about that meatloaf?
I don't mind telling you, meatloaf scared me.
Oh.
Well, you know, he wanted to hug me or maybe even kiss me, for heaven's sake.
Well, that's scary, yeah.
And it looks to me like he's starting to hang around with pirates or something. I don't know.
That's scary.
And let me just say one thing to you, Paul, regarding the orchestra.
Yeah.
Think about a tambourine player.
Yeah, right? Really. I know what you mean.
Actually, is another very amazing story. Our next guest's debut album, entitled Bat Out of Hell, sold more than 25 million copies. And now, after about 16 years, he's back with Bat Out of Hell 2, which is rocketed to number one and is nominated for 3 Grammys, one of which we understand he's already won for Best Rock Vocal Performance by a solo artist. Ladies and gentlemen, it's a pleasure to have him back here tonight. Meatloaf.
Of a broken heart. Think of how we lay down together. We'd be listening to the radio so loud and so strong. Every golden nugget coming like a gift to the gods. Someone must have blessed us when they gave us the song. I treasure your love.
I treasure your love.
I never wanna lose.
You're back, you're on top. This must be very satisfying for you.
Oh, it's a big honor.
Yeah.
And you know, what I do is a privilege, and I'm a luxury item. So I'm extremely grateful for anything that happens to me or anything that, you know.
Well, this is very nice. And we know that you've won at least one of these awards tonight, and maybe
I mean, that was, I found that, you know, and that's amazing.
Yeah. Good for you.
Thank you. I was emotionally moved, Dave.
Yeah, good for you.
Little tears.
You know, I like that song and the music. There's a lot of music. You get a lot of, there's a lot of feeling, a lot of music, a lot of everything going on there.
You get a lot with me, Dave.
Yeah.
You get a lot.
Let me, I know, now you probably covered this a billion times, but Dan Jansen wanted to ask me, wanted me to ask you how you got your name.
Oh, Dan asked you that?
Yeah.
Well, you know what? For Dan, I'll tell him.
Well,
okay?
That's what I thought.
I mean, he won a gold medal for America, you know? So anyway, there was this kid. I was in high school, and I had to go to a poker game. And I grew up...
It's a requirement of one of your classes?
Yes, it was. Yeah. It was a requirement. I grew up with some very wealthy individuals. Billy Underwood, from his father had Underwood's deviled ham.
Oh, man, they got
all
the money.
Yeah, they got some bread. And a lot of people like that. So one night we were going to a card game, and you had to have $100 to get in the card game.
Now, why didn't they call that kid deviled ham, then, if you're Meatloaf? Why isn't Billy Underwood deviled ham?
Dave, I've learned that when you say those things, just sit here and don't react. I've watched you enough, Dave, and watched all the people you've been with to just sit here and go,
that's right.
Yeah, that's right, baby. That's right. Whatever you say, baby, that's
you're a very wise man.
You just don't react. Oh, that's good, Dave. So anyway.
Ha ha ha.
So I don't know where I was in the middle of this story. No, I was playing poker. Yeah. So this guy, it's okay, yeah, it's okay. Right. I got a little over heated. And so the guy said to me, you need $100. He said, okay, I'll bet you $100 that you won't let the front wheel of that Volkswagen roll over your head. And I said, are you kidding? That's easy. So I put my head down on the ground, and three guys roll the front wheel, not the back wheel, because that's the engine part, roll the front wheel over my head, and is that funny? I mean, hasn't everybody done that for $100? So I won the $100, and after that, they said, you got meatloaf for brains, man.
Yeah, there you go. When did you wake up?
Oh, I probably won $1,100 that night.
Didn't it hurt? Didn't it knock you out? Didn't it squish you or something?
When you're 16 years old and you've had a case of Miller, you don't feel anything, Dave.
Well, there you go. Again, congratulations on the album. Congratulations on the Grammy or Grammys. And please, Meatloaf, whenever you're here, come back and sing
Dave,
for us.
Nice to have you with us. Thank you.
Meatloaf, folks. We're done, huh? We got to go. Thanks for watching. Good night, everybody. Our next guest is a Grammy-winning singer and one of the top-selling performers in all of rock and roll. His brand-new CD, of which I have a copy right here, is called Welcome to the Neighborhood. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back to The Late Show, Meatloaf. Here we go.
I'd lie for you. and that's the truth.
How do you do? Must be Mrs. Meatloaf. Nice to see you. Meat, how are you, buddy?
Hey, how you doing?
It's Meatloaf. Woo! We'll be right back.
I am really thankful that I do not contain any fillers or byproducts.
Yeah! Welcome to the neighborhood. Going to be another big, big album for you. Congratulations. Thanks for coming back.
Oh,
always
welcome,
a pleasure,
Dave.
To
thank
see you.
Thank you.
My thanks to Barbara Walters and Sean Penn. Next with Tom Snyder, or tomorrow, rather, Rosie O'Donnell and Gabriel Byrne here. And Tom Snyder is next. And my thanks to the cue card team. We'll see you tomorrow night, boys. Good night, everybody. Successful Grammy Award-winning singer, a fine actor, and now an author. Look at this. His very entertaining autobiography entitled To Hell and Back, and his new Storytellers CD was just released yesterday. Please welcome back to the show, Meatloaf, kid.
on and hit the fan.
We have a little if you need some. You know, this is, by the way, great job on the song. That's fantastic.
Thank you very much. I love that song.
Yep. Thank you. Zivon. Zivon, terrific singer, songwriter, isn't he? And a lot of the stuff he writes is very appropriate for you, don't you think?
It's absolutely appropriate, especially Lawyers, Guns, and Money.
Yeah.
All you got to do is read the book, you'll know that.
Yeah. And the other thing is, one of the lovely, talented singers in your band there is your daughter, beautiful.
My daughter Pearl.
Oh, my
she's 24
God, she's
years old. She's
24
she was
years
the blonde, yeah.
There you go. Look at that.
There she is.
She's just beautiful.
Off the old block.
No,
don't you
she's
think?
Not a chip off the old block. Are you kidding me? That's. The father of this woman is named Meatloaf. God, she's stunningly beautiful. Congratulations.
Well, thank you very much. My wife had something to do with that.
Well, sure, I know. But don't, hide your light under a bushel. And the other thing is, and I'm going to make this deal. I know nothing about show business. I'm going to make this deal in a minute. I'm going to place a call. We're going to get Tom Arnold to play your life story in the movie.
Oh.
You think? I think we're in business there.
I think he's perfect.
Hey, this book is pretty entertaining, too. There's a lot of interesting, a lot of amusing stuff, a lot of unpleasant stuff, but, that's the way life is, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Yeah, tell
it's
me
the
about,
way life is.
Tell me about your, you list, you have a history of concussions.
I do have a history of, I have 17.
You've been concussed 17 times?
17 times, yeah.
Wow. All right, pick one and tell us about it. If you remember
if I, was, that's what I was getting ready to say, can I remember? Well, pick one. Okay, I'm going to pick one. I think my favorite one is I went to Texas. Well, people
his
do
favorite,
have favorite concussions.
Favorite
I mean, come
concussion.
On. Don't you?
Yeah.
Okay. So I was on the Texas Tech campus, and Donnie Anderson, who used to play football for Green Bay Packers, he played for Texas Tech, and he had a girlfriend who was renowned for having large bosoms.
Mm-hmm. Well, this is a great story with your daughter here.
Well, you told me to pick one.
All right.
Extra large bosoms.
And then this somehow gave you a concussion?
Well, no, wait. Yeah, I got hit in the head by them. Bam! Okay.
That would be your favorite. Wow.
No, so anyway, I see her walking across the campus of Texas Tech, and I'm in my car, and I was following her, and I was actually driving, but I wasn't paying any attention where I was going, and I ran right into the back of another car
sure.
who had stopped.
Yeah.
And my head, this is going to be weird, got stuck in the steering wheel like this. And I hit my head on the, the...
Dash.
Thank you. It's from the concussion.
How long, how many years were you married to Roseanne Barr? Seriously.
That was my 18th concussion.
You know, you ought to do some more of them Warren Zevon songs.
I would love
that's a great combination. Here is the, this is from the Storytellers collection, the VH1 show, that's what it is.
Yeah.
Meatloaf, great to see you again.
Oh, nice to see you.
Congratulations on your daughter.
Thank you.
Beautiful.
Thank you.
We'll be right back. and gentlemen. My thanks to everybody, including Brian Donahue, whose favorite concussion took place just a few minutes ago, as a matter of fact, out there on the railing. The guy that fell down the stairs, Brian Donahue. Yeah. We'll see you tomorrow. Good night, everybody. Got that open string, open G.
I don't know. Did you have all five, all six strings on there?
That was nice. Thank
I don't
you
know.
Much.
They're cheating.
Very nice. You know, I got
that's six strings.
About a year ago, I went out and we thought it'd be a good idea to get a dog. So we went out and got what they call one of these. He's a mix. He's a half yellow lab, a half meth lab.
Oh.
And he's. Thank you. And. Boy, he's just as dumb as they come, and but a sweet boy, and everybody loves him. But he, the thing about dogs, they're scavengers, and as a result, it don't make any difference how much you feed them. They're constantly looking for stuff to put in their big old dumb jaws.
That's a problem.
And this dog will get in the pond, and he will trap fish. The dog taught himself how to fish, and of course, if you teach a dog to fish. Anyway, and so he eats and like carcasses, deer carcasses, you know, as he ought to be on the road crew. He's always picking up stuff that, you know, you can recognize vague anatomical parts in the dog. And we're constantly taking stuff out of his, you know, mouth and big jaws and stuff like that. And so now, a couple of weeks ago, he stops eating and he's acting a little lethargic. And you think, oh, well, he'll be fine. And then he kind of rallies, and then he starts acting lethargic, and then he rallies. So we get sort of worried about the guy, and he finally barfs up a rubber band.
Oh.
A rubber band, which means probably my giant wad of cash is gone. But that's another story. So... They take him to the vet, and they're going to observe him, and they find out that he's dehydrated, and they start scanning him, and sure enough, they discover some sort of intestinal thing, a blockage in his deal. And I didn't go to vet school, so I...
Okay, well, no, but you're doing
so
well.
So here was what we'll do. We'll put some barium in there, and we'll track it. And so they put the barium in the dog, and then every hour they take an x-ray. I mean, it's like the Weather Channel. You know, when a tropical storm is coming across the Atlantic, they'll keep an eye on that.
They track it.
Yeah. Well, so we're watching this mass headed toward the islands.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay.
And so last night, they said if it gets to the colon, you're home free.
That's beautiful.
Yeah, I know. I used to have that on a business card.
From your...
but it's... So this morning, just about 10 o'clock or so, they did another x-ray, and we got the call that it's, listen to this now, this was music to my ears. Because I'll tell you, the worst part of it is, the dog will be fine after surgery, you know?
Yeah.
It's this, it's the damn cone for 2 weeks.
Yeah.
I don't, it's
who
like,
wants that?
Like you're being attacked by your own furniture. Just ding, ding,
boink,
boink, boink, thunk.
Being boinked.
Yeah, that's right, being boinked. So we got the call today, ladies and gentlemen, and I'm so happy you're here to share the good news with me.
Yeah.
The word is now that it's breaking up and heading toward the colon. Thank you. Thank you very much. Breaking up is hard to do. Oh, my God. Oh, hey, look, it's time to play Is This Anything? Here we go.
Is this anything?
Alan, I understand tonight we have a celebrity judge on Is This Anything?
Yes, we have, Dave. Tonight's Is This Anything celebrity guest judge is Grammy Award winner and star of The Celebrity Apprentice, Meatloaf.
Oh, Meatloaf.
Good to have you here. Now, behind the thing, we have some performance going on. A man, woman, a boy, girl, child, could be any combination of them all. Could be a choir, could be tumblers, could be magic. We just don't know. They will come out and perform. Paul and I and Meatloaf will determine after we've seen the experience whether or not we think it's anything. That's how we play.
That's how we do it.
Meatloaf, you ready to go?
I'm ready to go.
All right, Paul, you ready?
Ready!
All right, raise the thing. Here we are, ladies and gentlemen. Paul, let's start with you.
Money in the bank.
Yeah. Meatloaf, what do you think? Is that anything?
I think that was very entertaining, like two women kissing on a subway.
Yes.
why couldn't we get that?
Yes, I would have to agree. I thought that, in fact, was
terrific,
something.
Yeah.
So congratulations, and that's how we play.
Is
this there you go.
Anything?
We'll be right back with tonight's top 10 list and Kate Hudson, everybody.